So let us look now at the overall performance and reliability of a RAID 4 array. For reads, we are getting, on average, the throughput of n-1 disks. We can read data from all of the data disks, but the parity disk has no useful data on it, so for reads, we don't use it. This is significantly improving read performance, because usually we have more than just two disks in an array. So for example, with four disks, we are really getting for reads the throughput of three disks, all of the data disks. For writes, however, the data accesses are distributed among the data disks. However, every write requires the parity disk to read and then write. We need to read the old parity, update it, and then write it back. So we are getting only one half of the throughput of a single disk, because the parity disk again needs two accesses for every write. This is a significant disadvantage, and we will see that this is really the primary reason why we need RAID 5. Now let's look at the reliability. What is the MTTF of a RAID 4 disk? Again, we have two options. Just like RAID 1, the first period we get is while all of the disks are working. The time we have during that period is on average MTTF of the single disk divided by n, because that's how long we have for the first of n disks to fail. Just like RAID 1, after this first failure, we did not lose the data yet. And now we have two options. If we do no repair of the failed disk, then now we are operating with n-1 good disks. If we do no repair of the failed disk, what we get now is at the point of the first failure, we are left with a n-1 disk array, and any disk failure in that array is going to result in data loss. So if we don't do repair, then to this, we add the expected time until the first failure among the n-1 disks that we still have. This plus this, if n is, let's say, 4, is not going to be better than the MTTF of a single disk. So you don't want to even consider using RAID 4 unless you're going to do repairs. So pretty much you don't do this because it's a bad idea. You're not getting any increased reliability. What you want to do is repair the failed disk, in which case the chances of a disk failing during the repair period is the MTTF of what's left of our array. With RAID 1, we had one disk left. Here we have n-1 disk left. So the MTTF for the remaining disks is lower than for one disk, because we are talking about the first failure among the n disks. So for example, if we have three disks, the first failure among three is going to happen sooner than the first failure among just the one disk. And then we divide that with the mean time to repair. So this is the factor with which we now multiply our, this is for how long we get a RAID 4 to work until we lose a disk. So overall, the MTTF of a RAID 4 array is going to be the MTTF of one disk times, again, the MTTF of one disk divided by n times n-1 times the MTTR for the disk. So note that again, you know, this is very small compared to this. So this particular ratio is extremely large. The number of disks is, let's say, 4. You don't want to have too many disks in a RAID 4 array. If that is so, then what we get is the MTTF of a single disk that is fairly large, multiplied by something that is usually in the thousands of more, and divided by something that is usually something like, you know, if it's 4 disks, it's going to be 12. So this MTTF of RAID 4, if we repair the failed disk every time it fails, we get an MTTF that is still very, very large.